Welcome to Oksana Live TV, the place to be if you want to create a love life of your dreams. And this is Q&A Thursday. Well, first of all, there seemed to be a huge misunderstanding and chaos that I created with my last couple of emails that I sent to you. One of the emails was titled to thank you for your order. Another one in the subject there was, it was said, I am upset with you. I want to let you know that these two emails, they came really from me. One of them, in one of them I explained that if you purchase my book, The Russian Allure, if you purchase it on Amazon, I asked you to contact us as soon as possible to confirm your purchase so you can get your book for free. Because we got a lot more orders on Amazon than we got confirmations from people who purchased it. So, and as you know, once you purchase your book, then you can send us email and you can get this book for free. Basically, we will credit your Oksana Love account with that amount that you invested into book purchase, including shipping fees and taxes. The second email where I said that I was upset with you had two links in it leading to the video where I explained you the reason why I was upset with you. You can still click on those links and see that video. Once again, don't worry about email, that your email being hacked or anything like that. I see now that maybe I had picked a little bit aggressive email subject for both of my emails, and maybe it caused you some sort of worry. And I apologize for that, that I got you a little bit nervous and confused. But listen, if you haven't claimed your free book yet, this book, yes, this book, then go back to your email, click on those links, and view my video message for you, okay? So tomorrow, Friday, is the last day where you can take advantage of this free offer. So once again, if you purchase, go purchase your book, email me a confirmation of your purchase to help@oksanalove.com, and I will credit your Oksana Love account with the purchase, including taxes and shipping fees that associated with your purchase. And you also get an additional gift. So go back to your message and you can see what that gift is all about. All right, moving on. Oh, I want to share one more fact with you. Apparently, Oksana Love is not only inspiring our members, but also it is inspires our competition. I see that the topics that I discuss here and questions that I address here and the questions that being answered here at Oksana Live TV are also being used by our competition to create video materials for their clients. Well, they could have, you know, at least said, you know, thanks Oksana or something like that for giving them all this inspiration. Anyway, apparently I'm making some serious impact with my Oksana Live TV, which is, you know, clear sign to me that I deliver great value and great content here, that even our competition has something to learn about the subject and something about this business. Anyway, all right, so let's move on to our Q&A today. Today's question is coming from Timothy, and he writes to me from Aurora, Colorado. And this is what Tim wants to know. At what point would it be appropriate to ask lady to deactivate her profile? Is this ever appropriate to ask? This is some fantastic question, Tim, and I know a lot of men and women are struggling with this exact question. For women, it is actually the same. They also wonder when it is a good time to ask men to delete his profile, to ask him to deactivate his profile from the database. So let me give you a little bit of a comparison. Dating blueprint versus car buying process. And seriously, they are so much alike, and I will show you how they are. So visualize this. When you are thinking about buying a car, the first thing you do is you shop around. You figure out the type of car you might want to buy. You check online, like dealership and car sites, maybe Craigslist, and you also check offline, which is magazines, maybe some print catalogs, for example. And you might also talk to people about their experiences about with the cars now that they have, and maybe it is the same car that you are thinking about purchasing, okay? So, well, let's go back to dating Russian women. It is the same process. You know, shopping around equals to site browsing, profile browsing. Now, print equals to catalogs, catalogs with the pictures and profiles, or maybe tour brochures. And talking to people equals to talking to married couples about two men about their experience with Russian women. So about hearing their stories and their experiences. All right, let's go back to car purchase blueprint. The next thing in car buying process would be to get to the dealership, right? Dealership loft and actually see the car, maybe even touch it, maybe sit inside of it, and you know, kind of, you know, see how it feels to get a feel of it. Dating Russian women is the same. You take a tour or you ask her out, and so you can meet her in person, so you can see how she looks, how she holds herself, and you know, maybe you can hold her hand and maybe give her a kiss, you know, so you're kind of testing waters. Now let's go back to car buying. The next step that you take is you take a test drive, right? So you want to know how this car feels while you're driving it and if you feel comfortable in it. Well, with women it is the same. Depending, of course, how much woman really likes you and how much you like her, well, you can test drive the relationship. But let me leave it right there. You know, how far you will go, I guess that is kind of a unique situation for everybody. With car driving, now, you either, after you test drive it, now you can either make a decision to buy this car right there at the spot, or you can, so you can take this car off the lot, or you can kind of think about it and you know you might come back a little bit later, right? So same goes for relationships with Russian women. You either know that she is the one for you and you ask her to marry you and you take her off that lot of singles market, or you think about it. All right, so the next step is your car registration. So we're going back to the car. The next step is the car registration. When you know the car, when you know that you really, really like this car and you know you're gonna get this car, you bought it, so what do? You register it. You make it officially yours. Or if you think, you know, the car might not be a right choice for you, so you kind of, you know, the car still doesn't belong to you. So you're in the process of thinking whether or not you want it, other people can look at it, they can test drive it, and maybe even buy it while you are thinking. Well, very fair, right? So relationships with Russian women is the same. If you want to claim your woman, if you want to kind of announce that she is yours, well, you marry her. Or so you kind of register the right to call her yours, the woman. And if you're still thinking about whether or not she's the right person for you, or if you want to register a relationship with her or claim your woman as yours, that means that you're not sure if you really want to announce the whole world and to all men out there, to all these potential buyers out there, that she is mine. Don't touch. This is mine. All right. So at what point can you call the car yours, right? Let's go back to the car. At the point where you claim it or bought it or register it. So at that point, you can really call car yours, that you are the owner of that car. Same with the relationships with Russian women. Once you're 100% sure that you want this woman in your life forever, once you claim her and make her unavailable to all other men out there by engaging to her or getting married to her, this is the point when both of you should get off the singles market. This is when you both getting off the singles market. Like my answer or not, but reality is this. There is no point of asking a person to make herself unavailable to all other men out there if you are not 100% committed to make this woman yours. Unfortunately, I seen it and keep seeing it all the time when people are making this huge mistake, when they remove themselves from the dating database and at the point when they start communicating to each other. but they haven't met each other in person. They don't even know if this person is right for them, and they don't even know if the other person is really 100% committed, and even if they will have some sort of chemistry or something like that. But these people make themselves unavailable, and then 9 out of 10 times they come back because the virtual relationship didn't lead to anywhere, didn't lead to anything serious. But at that point, they already seen by everybody else as a joke, because other people kind of see them that these people are not really sure of what they want. So my advice to you: don't deactivate your profile and don't ask others to do so in a process of your shopping around or test driving. Because if you fail with claiming or registration, you would need to do a lot of explanation. And you might lose also on this way, you might lose also that special person who is supposed to be with you. There's that special person who you're supposed to claim. And now I have a question for you. Okay, so in your opinion, when do you think it is appropriate time to ask a Russian woman to deactivate her profile? And also, what is the point do you feel that you should deactivate your profile? At what point of a relationship you think you should deactivate your profile? So would you please share your opinion once again? Just when do you think it is appropriate to ask a woman to deactivate her profile, and when do you think, in your opinion, is the good time when you should deactivate your profile? I am seriously curious to know the answer to this question. So thank you so much for sharing your opinion. You can share your opinion below this video in the comment section. And you know, sad but fact, this question is not being discussed in my book. But truly, it is a great question and something I should include probably in the future editions. But there is a lot of great information in my book, in this book right here. And I seriously recommend you to get it. The last chance you can get it for free is by this Friday, by 12, by midnight, California time, which is Pacific Standard Time. And so what you need to do is you need to go to Amazon.com. The link is provided right below this video. You can, after your purchase, you can email me your confirmation receipt, and you will be reimbursed with Oksana Love Credit, which will be posted to your agency account, and you also will get a surprise gift. All right, well, I hope you like this video, and if so, please share with all of your friends. There is a share button on the right side of the screen, and you can share with all of your friends via email, Facebook, or Twitter. So share in this video if you like it. If you want to see more great episodes like this one, make sure to log into OksanaLove.com and sign up for Oksana Live TV. So get on the list of emails to be notified when we have new video coming live. Keep looking for your special someone and never give up, because I promise you, she is out there and she's looking for you. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next Thursday on Oksana Live TV.